At the time I pushed the door, they put the AK-47 on my neck. Rabba Rabba!
Why do you call yourself Rabba Rabba?
Rabba Rabba is a businessman whom you know that he enter here, do everything. That's why people call me Rabba Rabba.
I thought you sell rubber.
Yeah, I sell things, you know.
Oh, you sell things, not just rubber?
No, not just rubber. To go to you, like when you have your shoe, you want to sell it, you are stranded, you tell me, okay, Rabba Rabba, I want to sell my shoe. Then I collect it and go and sell for somebody.
Rabba Rabba, I want to sell my clothes.
Yes, now I just go and collect it.
No, like, you know, I met Rabba Rabba here in Gambia, and then he told me an interesting story, and I would love, I don't want to listen alone, but I would love you to share with my fellow subscribers.
Yeah.
Because your story is really interesting.
Yeah.
I really feel like, when you were telling me the story, I felt like I was watching a movie or something, you know? Rabba Rabba.
Rabba Rabba, walk and live.
Thank you so much.
Respect,
for giving me the opportunity to
tell you this, man.
Rasta, man.
Walk and live. One family, one destiny. Some people call me Benghazi because I was in Libya.
Libya.
The time Libya was fighting, some of my friends, boy, Benghazi, your people are fighting. Go and help them. So this name also come. But my name is Usman Diop. I'm a Gambian.
A Gambian.
Yeah, I born in 1975, on the 10th of December, 1975.
You all need to hear this. Africans migrating from Africa, true story.
Yeah.
Rabba Rabba,
yes.
You told me that you wanted to go to Europe.
Mm-hmm.
You wanted to go to Spain.
Yeah,
right?
Spain, yeah.
What inspired you to do that?
Okay, what inspired me to go to Europe is to go and make something and come and develop my country and help my people, because I see many people going there trying, when they come, they can do a lot. So I was working in a company called ROC, called like Rock.
Okay.
Yes, so I was working there. And then this work, I earn like small salary and the whole family depending on me. So like, let's say $2,000. So when the end of the month, I buy a bag of rice, I give mom, and then little plants I give them. So I end up nothing. So I see that, look, this thing cannot go like this.
Wow.
I have to try and go out of Gambia and then go to Spain. So that's the time I plan my journey. So, but before that, I have a little bit problem where I was working.
Okay.
Yeah, so after then, the time I stopped that job, so I take them to Human Workers Union. They helped me to get my little balance.
Okay.
So that balance was $4,000.
Okay.
So I buy a bag of rice, I give mommy, then I give him $1,000 for fish money. So I left with $1,000.
You had $1,000 with you?
With me.
From
Gambia to Europe.
Mm-hmm. You said you're traveling without visa.
Yeah, without visa.
Can you tell me, what was your biggest struggle traveling without visa in Africa?
In Africa, my biggest struggle is between Libya and Mali, Matama. Matama is the last town of Mali and Libya.
Okay.
So there, you can see we are caught by rebels there. They drop us there. And you can see there also people, the whole truck, the driver and the whole 300 people, all of them die. Because the road is very dangerous. The driver can go and they lose the way and the petrol finish. Now all of them die. So the helicopters have to come and start collecting people. Some people, they bend down like this, just pray and after die there. So we pass all that road, and the rebels also will come with their AK-47, make you people to make a queue, and collect all, have 3/4 of your money. And by and force, there is no law there, they can kill you there. So they take some of our money there, and then we went to Libya. Gatrong is the first town of Libya. Then from Gatrong to Sabah to Tripoli. That's how I make the journey.
Rabba Rabba.
Yeah.
You made it out of this whole...
Telling you, from Libya, then I went to Algeria. There's a place called Magania. There are different nationalities in that place. It's a big hole. That's where people try to go to Melilla to find a connection man who will show them the road and go to Melilla. Then Melilla, then back to Algeria, then Algeria to Mali, Mali to Mauritania. Then that's how.
How long did it take you, your whole journey?
My whole journey took me roughly 4 years. I'm in this journey because I started with 1,000, I told you. So I started going and working.
Because you didn't have enough money.
I don't have enough money. And I can tell you, 6 months, you have to sleep outside. I was sleeping outside, like Africos, because no house. So you have to sleep on the bench.
Rabba, you know, like, you are really making me sad right now.
Telling you, my brother.
Because, like, what year was that?
That was 98.
1998.
I started my journey in 96, but this one I'm narrating to you, that was 98.
Wow. What was your final destination?
My final destination is Guinea-Bissau.
Guinea-Bissau.
I was planning to go to Cape Verde, because Cape Verde is an island. And this big Max Line used to come there, so I was planning to stow away boat there, this Max Line, to go to Portugal. If I arrive in Portugal, now I am in Europe. So, but so luckily I couldn't make it, then I came back to Gambia. Then
Why you came back?
I came back because my father died. They called me that your father passed away. Then I just came back to my father's funeral. Then that's the time I stay until now.
You came back to
back
settle
to Gambia,
down.
Yeah, settled down. Wow. Then after I came, I married. I have my 5 kids. My kids are going to school. I'm sponsored. I find a sponsor for them. They are sponsoring them.
Wow. Robert, you know, right now you made it out of this, even though you didn't go to Europe.
Yes.
But trust me, you are a big inspiration to so many young Africans out there who are looking forward to pass the
Bagway. Yeah.
You know, it's time for you to get your message out there, advise the youth who are looking forward to go for said journey.
Mm-hmm.
Robert, what are you going to tell young Africans out there?
Yeah, the young Africans, what I'm going to tell them, let them be careful on this Bagway. Because life is very expensive to go and just drop your life on this Sahara. The Sahara is very dangerous. It's very, very dangerous. And I'm praying to God, and let me make it a documentary. Let them sit down and watch this Bagway. The Bagway is very dangerous. Every day people are dying on a boat. People are dying on this Sahara. Because Sahara, you can see from here to how many thousand kilometers, you don't see no tree, no water. So everybody have to buy you 20 liters and go. If the water finish, sometimes you even urinate, somebody drink, and me, somebody also urinate because no water. So this is why I'm so trying to advise young people. I cannot stop you people to go there, but just to advise you, you take your time. And when this documentary come out, if I have a sponsor, I'm need of his help to bring this documentary out. Let the world see it, and let the African young Africans see it. Let them be careful on this Bagway. Yeah, I cannot stop them. If they want, let them go. But let them be careful. If I make it a documentary, they will see it.
Man, Robaroba wants to make a documentary
about Bagway.
About his journey through the Bagway.
Yeah.
And I believe that this story needs to be out there.
Yeah.
I believe that Robaroba needs somebody to sponsor this whole thing.
Yeah, that's.
And if you're a movie producer out there, we really wanna hear Robaroba's story. I'm gonna put a link in the description so that you can reach out to Robaroba.
Yeah.
Like, he's not even going into details, but he told me the whole story, and I was like, wow, this needs to be. A lot of people need to know what is
it.
Really happening.
Yeah.
Robaroba. Before I let you go, your final words to each and everyone, and also people who really want to sponsor you. Any message to anyone out there?
Yeah, what I want to say, I'm a young man who want to create this documentary and then to help the young people, let them save their life about this Bagway. So I am praying for everyone, let God help us, this documentary, let it go through. I'm looking for sponsor. I'm a young Gambian, I don't want to sit down like that. I want to go back through this ECOWAS documentary and then see it, let the world see it. I'm looking for a sponsor. Please, if you want to get in touch with me, follow this message.
There's gonna be a number over there so that you go check it out and come support
Robaroba
to bring the documentary.
It's
your boy Mr. Ghana, baby, still in the Gambia, and I don't know my next destination, but definitely I'm gonna see you in the next country.
Respect.
Robaroba. I am my
walk and live.
Good. Walk and live.
Walk and live, that you have to work hard.
Oh, walk and live.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, Robaroba.
Not too dependent. Right. You have to work.
Right.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Walk and hard live, you know.
Here in Kenya,
Amakure, Amazureze.
Let's get together, free or right.
Finally,
welcome to the giants of Africa.
I'm in the cleanest city in Africa.
Welcome to the Volta region.
I am 30 kilometers away from Dakar. Welcome to the only country in Africa that was never colonized. Go out there, go live your life, Go learn something new and make sure you explore. Kampala, Kampala, Kampala. Is that Kampala? Kampala, Kampala. I made history today. I know even my father was proud of me.